Students' Way, starting with the discussion of the first chapter of your book, Vistas, that is the third level. Now, before I start the reading of this chapter, there are a few things which I would like to discuss with you all. This chapter is science fiction. What is science fiction? Stories where we use scientific concepts, right? And when we do read about science fiction here, generally the most common aspect or the most common topic that we do come across is time travel. Yes? So, right, going into the past, going into the future. Yes or no? Yes? Right? So, if you have read books, you know, like, yes, so whether it is, you know, we've read Invisible Man also, that is something very, very, what you can say, a crazy kind of a possibility, where a concept of science has been used, right? You watch your movies also, where science has been used. And if you remember Jurassic Park, have you seen Jurassic Park? Yeah. There's so many parts of it, right? And there it is, you know, the present time. And of course, with things that have happened in the past. And they're showing that how it can be present, you know, possible now also. Then we have others, you know, like where we talk about things that are happening in the future, a possibility that these can happen. So whether it is the Martian, whether it's gravity, have you seen it? Yes, gravity, have you seen? I remember showing some of the classes in the lab also. Then there is about, you know, Inception. Have you heard of it? Inception? Or you watch only horror movies? Inception, right? So that is also about a thought process, right? Now, when we read about these science fictions, one thing is quite common. That is, we feel, you know, like the person who is undergoing this kind of a process, it seems as if this person wants to escape from reality. That he wants to go into the future or he wants to go into the past. Why is he not happy in the present? What is the problem with the present? Now, when you think of our busy lives, you know, you are as students and you might be saying that, ma'am, our life is so busy. We have a lot of problems. We have a lot of worries, right? So much homework and now we have practicals and tests and learning and everything. But later on in life, when you start pursuing a job, you're running a business or whatever, you realize that the problems multiply so many times, right? And there comes a time when you feel like, okay, I'm just stuck in this rote, you know, I'm just stuck in this same routine, right? And you want some peace. You want a break, right? And as you have grown up, you've heard your grandparents talk about the time when things were simpler, not so fast, and not everybody was so materialistic, how little things gave them so much of pleasure. Yes or no? Right? And then when you hear about that, you also want that, I wish I could live that life. I wish life could be so simple. Right? And nowadays, yes, when we are here in the middle of, you know, like the pandemic, and we're looking at so many things, and you want that, I wish things would go back to normal. I wish it would be like it was 2 years ago or 3 years ago and everything was normal and safe, isn't it? Right? And you know, sometimes in your daily routine, you feel like when you experience that moment, something happens with you and you think, it seems as if this had happened with me already. You have that feeling, isn't it? Right? So like you feel like, where did this happen? Generally, there's a term for it, you know, like a feeling that this has happened before. There's a term, we call it deja vu, actually, you know, like that feeling that you have experienced this moment before. Now, where could you have experienced it? Yes, in your subconsciousness, in your dreams, you know, maybe you've experienced it and you're sometimes very surprised, okay, I've lived this moment before. And you see it happening in reality, isn't it, right? Now, coming to the subconscious, it's something very, very powerful, yes. Right? Very powerful. And when you talk about your dreams, you know, people have tried to interpret dreams. People have tried to understand what dreams are about. Like, you know, you have a certain kind of a dream and it is giving you this kind of message. Sometimes you're so exhausted and tired, you don't even know what's happening. You don't have any dreams. But when you're stressed, when you're worried, then what kind of dreams do you have? What kind of dreams before the exams? Question paper. You want the question paper. I can't find my pen. I can't find my admit card. I don't know where the center is. Isn't it? Yes? You have much more important things to dream about. Okay, you're filling all your desires. But I feel, you know, people who do take things very seriously, they start getting these recurring thoughts about them. Where do we experience them? In our subconscious mind, right? And sometimes, you know, people, they go to the extent if they've had this idea or they've had their thought in their subconsciousness, they really want to find out that why did this happen to me and how did it happen to me? What were the things that were going on in my life that this moment happened, right? And, you know, like, yes, so like you're saying, you know, there's so many important things you have to dream about and thinking about the exams and the other stress-related things here. So when we have our dreams and when we have these beautiful thoughts in our subconscious, these are all a escape from reality. Okay, right? But what if this experience was actually real? And it was not something that was happening in your subconscious, or it was not something that was happening in your dreams. And you have evidence to prove. And you have evidence to prove that it really happened. How will you explain such a thing? You know, when you're not at peace of mind with yourself, with your life, with maybe your job, your expectations and all, and you start thinking that something is wrong with you. Whom do we go to treat all the problems that we have in our mind? Which person do we go to? Yes? You ask yourself only. You have the solution to all the problems which are there, right? Have you heard about a psychiatrist? Yes, we've heard about psychiatrists. Yes, at home students. Yes, psychiatrist deals with the mental issues. Now, when we talk about a psychiatrist, immediately what comes to our mind? I don't have to go to a psychiatrist. I'm okay. Right? Who do you think needs to go to a psychiatrist? And like what? Someone with serious mind issues? Someone with serious mental issues has to go? Is it? See, this is a very, very wrong thing. Very, very wrong perception, right? That we have. Sometimes what happens, you know, like you are there at that phase of life, you are at that stage of life where you are not at peace with yourself. You need to talk. And when you talk to your friends, when you talk to your peers, they are as experienced as you are. They're going to give you the same advice, right? So when we talk about depression and we talk about anxiety, we talk about, you know, like stress. These are things that really need to be dealt with. And it is a very, very wrong notion ki jo pagal hai wahi jayega psychiatrist ke paas. Right? That is what we think. And we feel ashamed also to talk about, okay, I have these kind of dreams or I have these kind of thoughts. And I'm feeling very, you know, low nowadays and, you know, like, or maybe I'm very stressed here, right? So what is the problem? Because at the end of the day, how is a life going to be comfortable? Is it going to be comfortable when you have a lot of money in your bank? Yes. Is it? Okay, fine. Yeah, okay. You're going to be very happy when you have a lot of money. You're going to be happy when you have money as well as peace of mind. Or you're going to be happy when you have peace of mind, but not so much wealth. Right? So at the end of the day, what is important? Peace of mind. You've been running your life. You've been rushing throughout the day and night and earning all these millions and trillions. And what happens at the age of 45, 48, you have a heart attack and everything is over. What is the use of that? He's alive. Okay, he's alive. Let's not send him away, right? So yeah, so at such a young age, what is the use of all this? When did you get the time to enjoy that money? No. So what do you think is more important? Our peace of mind. So whenever we are at unrest with ourselves, whenever we see that things are happening which are not making us comfortable, I think so it is time for us to talk to someone. And who's that person you need to talk to? We need to talk to someone who's qualified enough, right? We are at times unable to give ourselves the answers that we seek, because in our subconscious mind, we are going to give the answers that we want. Is it really what we want? Okay, right? You know, like nowadays here, yes, yeah, so maybe another important thing I'd like to discuss, this is a chapter that requires a very, very lengthy introduction, you know. We need to know about the power of our mind. Our mind is very, very powerful, right? Yes? We need to give a time. And yes, sometimes the thoughts that we have, you know, they govern our behavior also. They decide, you're always negative, negative, negative. Maybe it's going to show in your personality also, isn't it? Right? So that way, you know, your thoughts somewhere, they do reflect your behavior. So it's very important that you think nice thoughts so you get that good vibes and you get that good energy, okay? Right? So here in this, like you said, you know, like, okay, money is very important. Look what happened here last year. What did we learn? We accumulated so much of wealth, right? We've been working day and night. We have so much of money. But what was the use of that wealth when you are confined in your homes? You might be having 3 cars outside standing. Were you driving any one of them? Then you're not even going outside your gate, right? So what is there that is so important at the end of the day? It's a peace of mind. It is happiness. It is good health. That is very, very important, right? And of course, yes, it is also, right, very important that we have that peace, you know, between our thoughts and with our life. So that is what life is all about, maintaining a balance. Anyone, any doubt here? I'm going to start with the chapter. Yes, all of you, look at your books, please. Let me see how many have turned up today. Let's start here. Okay, now here, this is a kind of an experience here. We have the writer telling about an experience, a very strange experience that he had. Okay, yes. So like, as I discussed here, I think I have had quite a lengthy discussion there, that telling about that sometimes we have very strange experiences which are very, very difficult to describe, right? Now here, this is once again, it's about seeking that balance in the life, seeking that happiness in our life. And some people, they can seek happiness in the present. Some people think about, you know, like maybe the good old days that they talk about when everything was very nice and good and they want to go back to that time. Okay, let's start here. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. Please underline this. Two what? Two levels. Right? Levels for the trains to come. What is New York Central we're talking about? We're talking about one of the busiest and largest railway stations, right? So New York Central and everybody they're working over, they'll say that there are only two levels. So where did this third level come from? But I say there are three. So the narrator is saying there are three levels because I have been on the third level of the Grand Central Station. The whole world knows that there are only two levels, but he says, no, I found the third one also. I have been there. How did he go there when it's not there? Let's find out where he went. Yes, I've taken the obvious step. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine. So psychiatrist friend of mine. Why did he talk to him? He said, I can find the third level, whereas the whole world knows there are only two levels. And when you start seeing things that others can't see, what do you start thinking then? There's something wrong with me. Yes. You're different. But then why is it that how different are you that others can't see what you can? Right? Sometimes we do that to tease our friends also, you know, like, oh, we can't see this and, you know, pretend to be invisible or something like that to make them a little confused, isn't it? Right? So, of course, here, what is it? He is saying, I have been to the third level. The whole world does not know about it. I have found something. And so to get that peace of mind, whom did he talk to? A psychiatrist. See, he had no problem in talking to a psychiatrist. Why do we have? Right? You don't have, we, you know, it is nothing to be ashamed of. No one is going to brand you as mad or crazy or a lunatic or something like that. Right? So sometimes we have issues which need to be addressed, and especially when they are issues of the mind. If we don't ignore our physical health, why do we ignore our mental health? Right? Yes. I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine, among others. I told him about the third level. Third level, like you can say a story, a floor, right? Third level at Grand Central Station. And he said it was a waking dream wish fulfillment. What does this mean? Waking dream. Dreams with your eyes open. You're having dreams during the day. You're having a very unrealistic dream. Waking dream, wish fulfillment. So you're having a dream which is not going to be fulfilled, right? You're daydreaming. He said, I was unhappy. So he spinned it quite correctly. He said, why are you having these thoughts? Why are you having these ideas? Because you are unhappy, okay? Right? That made my wife kind of mad. Why is wife mad? Then am I making her happy, right? Is it? So of course she's angry that what is wrong with your life then? But he explained that he meant the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and all the rest of it. And that I just want to escape. Please underline these. Underline it. The modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and all the rest of it, and that I just want to escape. So sometimes it seems you want to run away from your responsibilities. You want to run away from the problems in life. And you wish I could go somewhere where it is peace and calm and quiet. This is what his friend told him. You are unhappy in life. Right? You're not satisfied with what is happening in your life. And that is, it is not necessary that your family is making you unhappy. No, it could be your own ideas, your own thoughts are making you unhappy, right? So it's very, very important to control what we think. Well, who doesn't? We all want to escape. Who needs a break? Who wants to escape? Right? Yeah, we need that escape. We need that break badly. But they don't wander down into any third level at Grand Central Station. He said everybody needs an escape. But what happened to him? He was the only one who found the third level at the Grand Central Station. Why is it that strange? Yes? Why is that strange? Tell me. Why is it strange to find the third level? Let me see your answers. Come on, quickly. Why is it strange to find the third level? Yes? Because it's not there, right? And when you find something that the whole world cannot see, it is something to be worried about, okay? Right, so he's very worried. He went to his psychiatrist friend, he's unhappy. When he told his wife, she was very angry. But then, of course, he said that this modern world is like this. We are somewhere or the other, we are unhappy, okay? Right. But that's the reason he said, and my friends all agreed. Everything points to it, they claimed. His friends also agreed that, yes, you are unhappy. Like, of course, maybe with your job, maybe with this daily routine that is happening. maybe because we have this insecurity. And I think so after this, you know, this has been such a turning point in our life, the pandemic, that it has made us value health even more. Yes, it has made us value our family even more. It has also made us realize that these things, they might keep on happening in the future also, right? So when you have that insecurity about that future, are you going to live your life to the fullest? Are you? There is going to be some little setback, isn't it? Right? Yes. Okay, now everything, my stamp collecting, for example, that's a temporary refuge from reality. What do stamp collectors do? What do stamp collectors do? Very obvious answer. What do? They collect stamps and stamps from the present as well as the past, right? So once again, they're saying your stamp collecting also does not allow you to live in the present. Where does it take you to? To the past. That makes it quite obvious also. That is why you are unhappy in the present and you want to be in the past. Okay? Right? What do we call a person who collects stamps? What do we call a person who collects stamps? Stamp collector. How nice. Oh my God. Why didn't I think of it? Stamp collecting is called philately. Philately. And a person who collects stamps is called a philatelist. Okay. So philately is that hobby of stamp collecting. Anybody into stamp collecting? Anybody into coin collecting? No? You are? Right. So you have coins from which time? Okay, you have, right? Yes. And like there are coins even before that, when you look at, So you have, of course, this show was about how things were in the past, right? And important years have a stamp, important years have a coin also, isn't it? Right? So every important occasion, stamps are released. Nowadays, we don't have stamps on. So we're not sending letters. Earlier people used to send letters. So the stamp was there, right? You send letters. Great, that's nice. Okay, right. Now, this stamp collection, the writer, he had inherited it from his grandfather. So he said, my grandfather was living at the time only when everything was so nice and happy. Then why did he go into stamp collection? What problem did he want to escape from? I might be having a problem in the present day. I want to go to the past. But what about my grandfather? Right? So why did he start that? So maybe our curiosity, we want to learn about things that happened in the past. We want to learn about the important, occasions and the important times there. So of course, stamp collection. Well, maybe, but my grandfather did not need any refuge from reality. Things were pretty nice and peaceful in his day, from all I hear. And he started my collection. So he is carrying on with his grandfather's collection. It's a nice collection too. Blocks of four of practically every US issue. First take covers and so on. President Roosevelt collected stamps too, So it is not only us, we have important people also collecting stamps, okay? So I am going to discuss about first day cover also tomorrow. I want you to find out about stamps a little more, right? So what are important occasions you can say have been shown on the stamp? When did the stamps in India change? Kind of stamps were there during the times of the Britishers and when India got freedom, how did the stamps change? The stamps, they tell a lot about history also. Yes? So here he's saying, I wanted to escape from reality, but what about my grandfather? Why did he start collecting stamps then? Why did President Roosevelt collect stamps? When you think the president, what problem would he have? Right? So why did he start that? Okay? Yes.